Good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to show you a setup that I have made a few years ago, but which is self-resonant. So I don't have a signal generator at the moment. The controlling is done by the gate driver over here, and it gets its signal from the receiver. So on the bottom there, we have the transmitter coil with a capacitor in parallel and in series. And then we have over here a receiver coil, which is tuned to that frequency. And if we look at the circuit, then we see over here we have our transmitting setup. And over here we have the feedback of our receiver to the gate driver input to control our pulses. And in this way we have a self-resonant system, but it is needed to place a plate over here on the receiver side, otherwise it doesn't work. Now in this circuit you only see four LEDs, but I could get to higher outputs or better output when I use six, so therefore in the setup you are now seeing six LEDs. Now I first started my experiments because somebody sent me in an older video a comment where he told me where the self-resonant setup could be powered by a Tate ambient power module. So I looked up that patent and how it looked like, and you can see that there is an antenna over here and there are two capacitors in both ways, and then we have two Avramenko plugs, and then we have two capacitors that are charged to earth ground. So that is what I first experimented with, but the results were not that good. So I thought, okay, what happens if I have more receivers that are foreseen of such a Tate power module? Now, for me, when I look at it, it's almost the same as Don Smith's setup. Because if we look at the setup over here, then you see that we have the same, how do you say, charging of the capacitor like we have with the ambient generator of Don Smith. So you pull in from Earth, but they can't go back through this diode. They can only go further to charge this capacitor. And because we have two polarities, we have over here a full bridge of what would be the ambient generator, what we see in the book of Don Smith, but then only with one side connected. Now, the one thing that I want to give with you for this setup, because I'm not able to go to self-running, I was able to go to 0.33 watts, and that's the least I can get. But the most important thing is when we look at the sine wave, then we see that when the capacitor is now charged to 91 volts, and I'm going to stop the signal, the scope, so I can better view to the frequency. So I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to change cursor. So this is approximately the frequency, 675 kilohertz, when that capacitor is charged. Now in the other setups, when we have charged or discharged capacitor, we had other frequencies or resonant frequencies by the impedance of that capacitor. So now I'm going to discharge this one. So it's a 200 volt LED. So as you can see, we are now, lose connection. So we are now discharged to 20 volts. And when I now go fast to there, do a single, then we see with even with a discharged capacitor, the frequency is exactly the same. Amplitude thus is changing but not the frequency. And that is important when we go back to the setup like that one from the previous video. And that is why I want to make this small video, although I cannot create a self-runner. I think this could be very helpful by also in that setup of the previous video where we place two capacitors in series with the antenna and after that charging the capacitor. Now, something also I want to give with you, I experimented with one nanofarad capacitor and with one microfarad capacitor and it doesn't change anything to the charged graphics. You will find the pictures in the link to it into the video comments. But the most important thing that I want to give with you is that from this setup that I learned that I'm able to over here shut off the feedback of the impedance of that capacitor that we are charging. So we don't have that much influence on the resonant frequency. So hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.